Hey YouTube, this is Jaden from Team Shadow Strike coming at you with a new deck profile. This is a deck profile that I was requested to do because if you guys had watched my last OTT deck profile, I did a deck profile on Full Moon, and the last version I'll probably ever do a Full Moon, but that's why I say probably. Maybe later down the road I'll do another one. As you're aware, Set 9's coming out, and we get the crossfire for CEO. CEO Amaterasu was the Oracle Think Tank boss monster that was released in Set 1, which was forever and a day ago. And I asked in that video if anybody wanted to see just my basic deck list right now of a CEO deck profile with just the grade 3, not the crossfire yet. And one person asked for it, so I thought, hey, what the heck, since at least one person asked for it, I'll post it, and if anyone wants to see it, it's here, and if not, oh well. But anyway, this is, it was requested by ThatBolt721. Hopefully I remembered it correctly. ThatBolt721, specifically to you since you requested it. Here it is, and let's get into this deck profile. First off, we start with our grade zeros as usual. We have a new starter. I use, in this build, I am using Battle Sister Eclair. It is the one that, it's the same type that can slide back when another OTT rides it. You can counterblast one, move it into the soul, and you can search the top five cards for a grade three. Now, since CEO is the boss of this deck, obviously you want to try and get the Mega Blast off if you can. Obviously, you're also not going to want to use her skill if you open up with a grade 3 in your hand. So that way you can save it for CEO's Mega Blast if you need it in late game. But it's there if you need it. And if you do need it, 9 times out of 10 with the way the heal triggers seem to pop up in Oracle Think Tank, you're going to heal at least once and you can heal this damage. And then you're set up for the Mega Blast again. So this is mainly just here in case you don't hit a grade 3. We play a grand total of 7 critical triggers. I play the 4 Psychic Bird. The Soul Charge and Draw 1 helps you get those 8 cards in the Soul that you need for CEO's Mega Blast. And other cards in the deck. 1 Oracle Guardian Nike and 2 Battle Sister Ginger for a grand total of 7 critical triggers. We just mix them up a little bit so our opponent thinks we might play 12. Which is not a bad option, I just prefer to have other options other beside critical triggers. That's just me. I'm not saying it's bad. But I wanted to play 6 draw trigger in this deck and go 6 crit, 6 draw. But believe it or not, guys, I only had 1 extra draw trigger for Oracle Think Tank. So I'm playing 3, what's his name? Miracle Kid and 2 Dream Eater. If I had 1 more Dream Eater, I'd play 3 of each. So 5 draw trigger right now. If I come across another Dream Eater, I'll probably take out the 1 Oracle Guardian, one of the Gingers, and stick in a another Dream Eater to play 6-6. And then, of course, we play the 4 heal trigger, 2 of each print, because I like them both. But I will say, if you, by any chance, since have SPs of the Lozenge Magus Heal Trigger, please let me know. I want them. Next, we move to Grade 1s. We play 4 copies of Battle Sister Chocolat. It's the perfect guard. Not going to say anything else. You need 4 perfects, period. Then we play 4 copies of our 8K booster, Oracle Guardian Gemini, simply because behind our CEO, it's an 18, gets pushed up to 22 when she have 4 cards in the hand, and behind other cards, it can make them hit magic numbers. So Gemini is just really good. Then we play 3 copies of Battle Sister Coco, and this is a card I haven't played in a while. Mainly because in Full Moon, I really don't think it's necessary. But it's basically a mini CEO. When it's called to the rear guard or you ride it as your grade 1 vanguard, you get to preview the top card of your deck and decide whether to leave it on top or bottom. Other than that, it's just a 6K boost, but it is a good card. I will definitely be playing this in my son Amaterasu build. two copies of Dark Cat. These are mainly just here as 7K boosters, and also because it helps you draw another card. So, good option. And then we play two copies of Weather Girl Milk. It is the 10K booster for Oracle Think Tank. If you have four more cards in your hand and she's boosting the Vanguard, she boosts for 10, and we play one of each print. This is the one that came out in set one, and this is the one that came out in the trial deck not too long ago. Even though I think that one's prettier, I thought I'd just go old school and play one of each just to kind of show the history of Milk, I guess. I don't know. I'm weird. Leave me alone. Grade 2s. 4. Silent Tom. Silent Tom is still one of the best cards in the game. I do agree with Crossrides. He does lose a little bit of his pip, but I still love Tom, so I'm still going to play 4 of him, at least for now. I might go to 3 eventually. Then I play 4 copies of a card we haven't seen in a while either, Battle Sister Mocha. And that's because these were taken up with Full Moon if you play Oracle Think Tank. But you could probably still play these in Full Moon, you probably just couldn't play 4. Battle Sister Mocha is the easiest 11k attacker that I know of, because more times than not in Oracle Think Tank, you're going to have 4 cards in your hand. So, and since I don't play stand triggers, you can attack with the Vanguard first and get an extra 2, 1 or 2 cards in your hand to make her an 11k. So she is so easy, and that's why to get to 11k, and if you get an 8k booster behind her, that's 19. So she's just too good not to max out on. And then 3 copies of Battle Maiden Tagitsu Hime. When there's 6 cards in the soul, which is real easy to pull off when you have CEO as your Vanguard and using the Psychic Birds, or you use the skill of your Vanguard starter to get an early start, she becomes a 12k attacker. Because she gains 3,000, pushing her from 9 to 12. And with Gemini behind her, she hits for 20. That's amazing. So, grade 3s. Now, the first grade 3, we're playing 3 copies of Epitome of Knowledge Silverest! I'm just kidding. These are just proxies because I, for some reason, do not have any copies of, I think it's Battle Sister Souffle. It's the 12k attacker for Oracle Think Tank. I didn't want to play Meteor Break Wizard because that counterblasts and that makes it harder to pull off CEO's Mega Blast, so then you got to play Souffle. So these are just proxies for 12k attackers for Oracle Think Tank Battle Sister Souffle, mainly just because it's kind of like a replacement for Tagitsu Hime when she dies if you had 6 cards on the soul, because if you have a Gemini behind Souffle and she attacks, she hits for 20. So you can have your Mochas with 19, you can have your Tagitsu Himes for 20, and you can have your Souffle for 20. So you can have 19 20k columns easy with this build. But there's really nothing else this card is good for except to hold on to and to think, man, the one grade 4 that there was in the game, and when it came out, we got a grand total of a month and a half with it, and unfortunately, when I finally got my Great Nature deck built, it was banned. You know, but oh well. I'm not gonna get rid of these just because this is, if there ever is another grade four in the game, this is where they started, and I'm sure these will be worth something someday. But anyway, 3 copies of Battle Sister Souffle, and then 4 copies of the, I don't want to say boss, I'm gonna say the bitch of this deck. A very controversial card. If you do not know how her ruling works, I made a video a long time ago about it. Go watch it. It's called the CEO ruling. 4 copies of CEO Amaterasu. Now, I'm going to read all of her effects, and I'll kind of do a mini explanation of that video, but if you really want further explanation, go to the video on the channel. It's called the CEO ruling. But anyway, first effect, we'll start from the bottom, because the first effect is actually the most important. Auto, Vanguard, or Rear Guard. Soul Blast 8, Counter Blast 5. When this unit's attack hits, you may pay the cost. If you do, draw up to 5 cards. So that's the Mega Blast. I pulled it off because I used to play 3 CEO in Full Moon, and believe it or not, there was one time when I rode CEO as my Vanguard because I couldn't find Full Moon, and her Mega Blast ended up winning me the game. So, and CEO has always been one of my favorite cards, just because I like being able to preview the top card every turn. But anyway, That's her Mega Blast. Second ability, Vanguard. At the beginning of your main phase, Soul Charge 1. Look at the top card of your deck and put that card on the top or bottom. If it's a top, if it's a trigger, you're going to leave it on top. If it's not, you shove it to the bottom. This is mainly to ensure you hit triggers every single time you attack. Being able to at least ensure that you're going to hit at least one trigger is really good. And then the final ability, the one that there's been so much controversy about, during your turn, and this is a continuous Vanguard ability. Keep in mind, continuous means it doesn't matter when the effect is met, if it's met in the ride phase, the draw phase, the main phase, the end phase, the tango phase, the politician phase, the toilet phase, the jack-off phase, no matter when it's met, it is active at that point until the end of turn. During your turn, that means just you, the card's owner. If the number of cards in your hand is 4 or higher or greater, this unit gets plus 4,000 power. So if you have 4 cards in your hand and you just drew, she's automatically at 14,000 power. And if you can boost her with a 10K booster, that's 24,000 power, which is pretty damn good. That is my CEO deck profile, and that Bolt 721, I hope, especially to you since you're the one that requested this, I hope it was informative, I hope you enjoyed it, I hope everybody enjoyed it for that fact. CEO's just, it's one of the classic decks of Vanguard over here in the United States, because we're getting ready to get into set 9, but there is a cross ride coming out for CEO. I will be looking for them. I need probably at least 3 copies. And when I get everything that I need for the deck, I will post an updated, I will post a deck profile of the sun for you. That's what it's called. It's called, Goddess of the Sun Amaterasu. If you'd like to know the name of it, it's the cross ride for CEO. It's the same as all of them. Real quickly, I'll tell you what the sun does. When you ride her, if CEO's in the soul, she gains 2,000 power, so she'll be at 13k at all times. And then her ultimate break skill is counterblast. It's either 2 or 3. Believe it or not, I think it's only 2, and if so, that's pretty stupid. And it's if her attack hits, you can counterblast. Like I said, I believe 2, but it might be 3. You counterblast, and you get to search your deck for 1 Oracle Think Tank unit and add it to your hand, which is stupid. So, I'm really looking forward to building that deck. They're also getting a 12k attacker, so, with the 12k attacker they already have and Mocha, I mean, I think this deck can really be pretty high powered. It's going to be kind of draw power aggro. So, anyway, this has been a deck profile on my right now just CEO deck profile. Like I said, I will post an updated deck profile on CEO once the sun comes out. And hope you enjoyed it. Hope it was informative. You got any comments, questions, or concerns, or you just want to use the greatest invention in the world, the internet, to post your opinion, just feel free to stick it down there in that comment section. Tell me what you think about the deck. This is, I've been thinking about actually slapping this deck together for anyway, because I just wanted to try it and see how it worked, but, to try and kind of get some ideas for the sun. But anyway, in the comment section, give me your opinions, leave a comment if you'd like. But anyway, comment, rate, subscribe, all that stuff, and I will see you guys later. Thanks for watching.